This isn't gonna end well.
Today we're on a mission that's a little esoteric. We're measuring the height of trees as accurately as we can. We've got one team out and about in Central Park, and another in Northern California, home to some of the tallest trees in the world.
This is awful. We're so uncomfortable.
Corey is gonna be jealous.
It's all for a good cause. NASA asked us to. Actually, they asked everyone to.
It's a really big tree.
They're trying to mobilize an army of citizen scientists to help double-check the work of one of their newest satellites.
We have good indication of separation of the ICESat-2 spacecraft.
And we're not going to let them down.
That's a good tree.
42 degrees at 50 feet.
The satellite that we're assisting today is called ICESat-2. It was launched in September of 2018 with a pretty remarkable goal. It's measuring the height of everything on Earth. Land, ice, water, and vegetation like trees. Every 90 minutes, ICESat-2 completes a lap around the planet, and along the way, shoots pulses of lasers down to the surface. Using the speed of light as a constant, NASA can calculate the distance between the ground and the satellite. This gives them a line of height measurements wherever ICESat-2 flies. So orbit by orbit, NASA receives increasingly dense lines of data that span the globe. They're just not sure how much they can actually trust their readings.
Turned into a pretty crappy day.
I have no idea how we're gonna get far enough away from the trees to get a good measurement of them, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
We're getting involved because NASA really wants to find out the height of forests. We know that about 30% of the Earth is covered in trees, but that's a two-dimensional measurement. It doesn't give you a sense of the sheer tonnage of trees out there. For that, we need volume. But trees are really hard to measure from space. When a laser hits a tree, photons bounce off the canopy, off leaves somewhere in the middle, and off the ground. Scientists have to suss out which photons bounced off what, and sometimes the satellite only gets a single photon back. The point is, there's a lot of calculation involved, and NASA would love for us to check their work.
We can try this one.
The app NASA built to get us involved is called Globe Observer. We installed it on our phones and called NASA up for a walkthrough.
So my name is Holly Cole. I am the project coordinator for Globe Observer.
NASA's app is a part of a broad program to engage the public with environmental sciences. With the app, anyone can take measurements of land cover, clouds, mosquitoes, and tree height. All those measurements have different uses for different researchers. But for trees, it's about matching the data we're collecting with what ICESat-2 sees when it flies over that same area.
The satellite does have global coverage, so, you know, at some point in the future, it will fly over and then fly over again and again and again. And so as we collect more and more data, we're providing a wider database for those ICESat-2 scientists to draw from as they start to validate what their satellite's telling them.
The app is pretty user-friendly. First, you tell NASA how tall you are. That'll come in handy later. Then, pick a tree.
Okay, we're gonna try to record the height of this very tall tree.
To measure a tree, you hold the phone at eye height, point the camera at the base of the tree, and take a picture. Then pivot the phone back without changing its position in front of you, and snap a photo of the treetop. Once you have both photos, the app will ask you to walk from where you're standing to the base of the tree, and record your number of strides.
It's gonna be a bit of a hike. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 52, 53, 54, 55, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, call it 73.
This gives the app everything it needs to estimate the tree's height.
49.3.
Now, how did the Globe app turn a couple of photos and steps into a height measurement? Well, our younger viewers might have figured this out already.
If you think back to high school, you'll remember that if you know the length of one side of the triangle, and then the two angles, the right angle, and then one other angle, you can calculate the length of the other side. And that's what we're doing.
Basically, the app is doing trigonometry. Picture a right triangle where side A is the tree. The app guesses side B, the ground, based on how many steps you take. And it uses your phone's gyroscope to measure the angle opposite the tree. That's enough to calculate the tree's height, which is side A of the triangle plus your height. Just for fun, we check the app's work with a clinometer, pen and paper, tape measure, and calculator. A little bit of shaky math later, and we had an answer that exactly matched the average of our three readings.
It's 50.3. Will's gonna get a redwood that's like 300 feet tall.
So the calculated tree height is 292 feet and 4 inches. The actual height is 286 feet, and that is pretty darn close.
Back in the office, we saw that our measurements were already published to the Globe website for anyone in the world to see and use. But we wanted to know what scientists might do with our data, so we called one up. Paul Montesano, a research scientist at NASA. Paul studies forest height and density in places like Alaska and Siberia.
And I study these forests primarily using remote sensing data, data collected from satellites or airborne platforms.
Paul says that Globe app data can check more than just ISAT-2. He relies on airborne flyovers of forests, which use a similar laser measurement technique to paint incredibly detailed pictures of tree heights. And he measures trees on the ground himself, and uses satellite data too. If it sounds like a lot of overlap, that's the point.
If you only have one measurement, you don't know how wrong you are. All measurements are off, right? A measurement is just an estimate.
We're not under any delusions. Our own measurements are tiny, tiny drops in a huge bucket of data that scientists like Paul use. But by mashing up all the available data, scientists can build more and more accurate pictures of forests around the globe.
And so we'll have this like multi-tier system of sort of scaling up our most accurate and precise measurements from the ground to the satellite platform.
Which brings us to the final question. Why? Why catalog all the trees and all the forests in the world? There are a lot of reasons, but many boil down to one word, carbon.
One of the overarching goals, I guess, of Earth scientists today is to understand the carbon budget.
Human activity produces a lot of carbon dioxide, which alters the overall carbon budget, the net flow of carbon through different areas of the planet. There's a big pool of carbon in the atmosphere, another dissolved in the oceans. And on land, gigatons of carbon are found in forests. Maybe half of a tree's dry weight is carbon. If scientists can figure out how much tree matter there is on Earth, they can guess at how forests will change the amount of carbon in the air, as humans pump more in.
Are these forests serving as a source of carbon to the atmosphere? Or are they serving as a sink of carbon, sucking up more carbon than they're giving off? So we're interested in sort of the net exchange of carbon from the terrestrial pool.
Those are big questions, but finding answers means zooming way in, from satellites sweeping the forests of the world, all the way down to individual trees, and measuring them, sometimes one by one, just like we did.
I think I've roughly measured either the diameters or the heights of maybe about 15,000 trees in my life. It's a lot of work.
Hey guys, if you download the Globe Observer app yourself, Holly and Paul have a couple of requests. First, measure your stride length, and second, don't forget to measure the same tree a couple of times. Those things will help improve your accuracy. Thanks.